The other day, I was scrolling through my social media feed when something caught my eye. I was like, was this an Apple keynote event? Oh wait, no, it's Procreate. Since when did Procreate become so Apple-like? Whatever. I then sat through the entire 30 minutes of their CEO presenting this new product, and you know what really impressed me? Cutting-edge technology? Nope. Seamless animation tools? Nope. Magic timeline? Nope. It was in fact... Are you ready for this?
For a once-off purchase of $19.99
USD! One-time purchase! Are you kidding me? That is insane! Compared to what I'm paying for Adobe Animate, this is almost too good to be true! Dear Adobe, it's 2023. Stop ripping us off, will ya? Anyway, I'm gonna dive into what I really think about this app and how it changes everything. So besides it looking really a lot like Procreate, the first thing I noticed was the user interface being almost identical to the original, so we won't get lost like every single time we try a new app. Noise! The greatest feature in my opinion is how you can pinch zoom to move in and out within your animation space. Because Procreate is made for the iPad, naturally they would base their entire design off pinch and zoom gestures. Using other tablets like Wacom, it feels almost painful to not be able to use gestures while working on screen tablets. I draw a cat, I don't like it, I pinch here and there, only to realize, well shit, this ain't working. Also, Procreate's mega timeline lets you pinch zoom in on any frame, so you'll never feel lost in your workspace again. Pretty handy for people who love hundreds of layers. I've lost count of how many times I need to use the slider in Animate to move through my frames. Talking about productivity, huh? Procreate Dreams operates much the way a 2D animation app would. Frame by frame, cell animations to be exact. And because it's built that way, you can double tap and move into any specific frame of your animation you need to work on. Really handy for some of us illustrators that need to edit some parts of the animation on the fly. Next is the brushes. Anyone familiar with Procreate would appreciate how much thought they put into their brushes, compared to your standard animation apps where brushes ain't really that intuitive. I mean, I use Animate and Toon Boom, but there's something about Procreate that feels more natural, more smooth, more yummy, just like ice cream. The third and probably the feature that I love the most is audio. Previously, drawing and animating on Procreate didn't allow you to add any audio to your works. I'd have to export my work into other software like iMovie or After Effects or Animate to be able to mix in soundtracks and sound effects. Well, Procreate Dreams just made my dreams come true. The new audio engine will allow us to edit audio in real time, mixing and cutting up tracks easily within the app without the need for another video editing software. I seriously can't wait to test this out. And I'm sure there are tons of other really great features, but at this moment, all I can say is November can't come fast enough. You know how much we love Procreate. Like, come on, animating a 5-minute clip could take me like 2 months because the app was not designed for animation in mind. Yet. And now, the dream is about to come true. But my biggest question is, can it run on my iPad? I mean, mine isn't the latest model and I'm definitely not gonna break the bank just to test if this app is as amazing as they make it out to be. But yeah, most questions will likely be answered come November. Again, this isn't a sponsored video and I'm not dreaming when I said this is gonna be the next level animation app on the iPad. I'm just giving my opinions, you know, because Procreate? Besides, sharing is caring, am I right?